Timokov thought he'd won the ball, but penalised. Good decision by the referee. The referee is from Ecuador this afternoon, Mr. Guido Gonzalez. His assistants, both from here in China. Now, you'll just notice with the throw in there, one of three rule differences between football at the Paralympic Games in the seven-a-side, differing from those in the Olympics. And throw-ins may be made with one hand, and a player is allowed to roll the ball in such a way that it touches the ground immediately after it's released from the player's hand. So no throw-ins from over the head, just sort of rolled in, as we've seen a couple of times in this match already. And the other main difference is that there's no offside rule. There is a third rule that only 10 goals scored will be allowed to be counted for in the goal difference column in the event of a hugely one-sided match, but that doesn't really affect us here. It's winner takes the gold. Off with the yellow card. And it was his cross, but no one there to meet it. Well, not from his side anyway. Both teams top their group in the preliminary stages. With three wins out of three. Russia beat Brazil 3-0, China 6-0, and they beat the Netherlands by 12-1. Of course, just 10 of those 12 goals counting, but it didn't really make any difference. They were well clear at the top of the group, just conceding that one goal against the Dutch. And Ukraine also conceded just the one goal. 4-0, they beat Iran. 7-0, they beat Ireland. And 8-1, they beat Great Britain. neither team conceding in their semi-final victories. Venue here, the Olympic Green Hockey Stadium. You can see some of the lines have been coloured in and new lines drawn on top. Crowd doing their best to try and urge on the players. Samashka came out pretty well there. His opponent, Andrei Kaveev, who scored 7 goals in this tournament so far. He's the top scorer for the Russians. Samashka, again, with a block. Well, it's certainly picking up now, and a blatant pull there. I think we might just see a yellow card. There we go. Ivan Potekin. He completely lost his man. Alexander Devilish was well clear. Little tug of the shorts. Just as well he had his underwear on. Potekin goes in the book. Second card of the game. Kavayev, the top scorer. Mervanadze drills a fierce shot in there. Samashko is equal to it. The Russian coach, Avtandel Baramidze. So, hey, Vakalenko there for Ukraine. He's the category 6 player on this Ukrainian side. The classification can be a somewhat delicate matter. There are instances where players not happy with how they've been classified by the officials. Everyone is different, of course, and sometimes just not quite fitting exactly into the usual guidelines. So a couple of minutes plus injury time to go here in this first half. Chesmin's cross, just trying to find Kovaev. Well defended by Taras Dutko. Kovaev just striking a ball with his hand on the way up. Samashko opted to push it away. Possibly could have grabbed that one. No, just to be one more minute at the end of this first half. No score so far between Ukraine and Russia here in the gold medal match. Tignac, the captain there for Ukraine. Winning the throw-in, but no time to take it. So, scoreless at the end of this first half. Kovaev there, the number 10, You'd expect him to be the danger man. 7 goals in this tournament so far. And plenty of Russian fans there in the crowd to cheer him on.